Committee. And today we are joined by council members, Levine, and Casas is on his way. Today we will be holding hearings on a number of applications. If you're here to testify, please fill out one of the slips. Our first hearing is on LU 312, an application by Carrie's Hospitality LLC for a new revocable for an unclosed sidewalk at 160 Franklin Street in now open the public hearing on this application. And we will be calling Simon Robinson and Heather. Turn on your microphone and get into the panel.
First, please state your name. Do you each swear or affirm the testimony to be the truth, the whole truth? Your name?
Heather Kirk.
Yes.
For my clients, Paul Longa of Elder Green, I want to first thank you here before you on the sidewalk cafe restaurant and bars located on Kent Street. The application is currently stands is to request 11 tables and 22 chairs. We met with the local state and during these meetings, my client received both support as well as some residents that Express can have. We have been opening also allows us business.
Franklin, I just want to keep it short, as in we've been there 8 months.
I've met I just wanted to talk a little bit. 8 months.
And as well, that also was located on Kent Street. It was for
Street. There was also part of it was on Franklin Street as well.
Correct. But
Dunbar, but they
and they close a shorter time than that, or you know, that you couldn't serve alcohol. Can only be during the time that your kitchen is open, right?
That's correct. Through at 11.
Petition that's gone around and can you
have been closed them at
and then obviously we removed one or two speakers that keep going forward, you know.
Mm-hmm. So with week talk thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Council Member. Thank you. Seeing none, I now close the public hearing on this application.
possibility that we'll get email testimony from.
Yeah. Amendment to establish a mandatory inclusionary housing. Action one.
Apologize.
No, please.
Testimony that you're about to give truth, nothing but the truth, and to answer all.
So will be I see that in front of me story building. They are 4.59, which is pretty comparable. Uh, 30% of the dwelling units, which equals 11, thank you very much, operate the Shell stations in New York City. You might be wondering, that's because this station is severe, as well as with the facade, Bridge Street Development Corporation, to comply with the notions you may have. Go through the application in greater detail. There's large and older, smaller model with a new gas station, not in this district, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. Gas stations for the proposed
is 18 two bedrooms, is that right?
Yes, that is correct. That's correct. As far as the unit improving, if you should, or acting upon a reason. Right, or three bedroom units. Came up with the community. Decision came up.
In terms of paying prevailing wage,
as far as I think really positive that everything. All support the local retail, and as we all know, the local retail is in. And
I know that the one about it that they have.
Yeah.
And thank you, Bell, Jonathan Slipowitz, Schulman.
Schulman, yes, I. Good afternoon. My name is Richard Lobel of Sheldon Shoes. Experience in the which would rezone this parcel as well as parcels with a residential building with mixed use. Which would place this. The rezoned block, and to include the block within the transit zone, rezone. Or so. What really does this mean? It means several things. In accordance with reasons, this is one of the reasons we're happy to be here with Enclave. And again, you can see. Now I would hand it over to Emmanuel, who's going to discuss some of the.
The Afghan architect, thousands map, and three street fronting. We have a the roof and floor, so in feet. And then on the next slide, we have the second floor of units.
Actually, they're 25% at 60 or 30.
At the request of the borough president to accommodate their request, so.
Which will be permanent housing. This is not transitional housing. People move in, they have a lease. Based on.
Says being able to.
Hand over to Councilmember Cohen.
Thank the community. This project, this is the very end of the sub. Used it all, in my memory. Commercial potential. Worked closely with labor. We're not voting today. Project. So, thank you.
Thank all of you for your testimony here today.
And I have been a member of 32BJ for 2 years, Economy in New York City. The of this broad permanent housing, especially we believe this project urge you to
Are there any other members? Two, the 5153 White Street special seeking is 711 of the zoning resolution to modify inner court regulations and minimum distance. Becca,
state your name.
Characterized by mixed-use buildings with a majority of building heights of 5 and street wall, 12 to 38 feet, pushing the bulk back from the street and from existing major restorative work in Phil and the so this shows the waiver for height and inner court and small 3 foot in fact this building is in keeping with a lot of the what would be normally required on the upper floor. Up actions. We did get a community board level. We had unanimous approval of the design at the LPC hearing. And when we synagogue continuously, any neighbors that have a stake in this to
thank you. Just a couple as requested.
And
okay.
Street from any point of public way on top of the building. And if as long as they won't be visible from the street, we
significate this impact during
so that under keeping debris on our site and air safe. All rules.
And are there any other, Chervin?
Sure that the,
you may be.
For permit. On the 11 HVAC units that will be posted, so access to air and sunlight. We're worried about to be late 2017 when lead paint was sand off of a
yes, there is. It's on the outside of the northeast corner. Way and there is matched up to the 11 to 12 HVAC units that we have will create
down
over here. Yep. Our next public hearing is on LU 9 Greenwich Avenue to provide and to monitor the building.
Before questions, truthfully,
I do, Judy Gallant. He has applied in favor. Okay, and drinking on the second. Just like to note that if the 74/7/11 the highest salon and products to New York City and restore the vibrancy on
is going to be for the second floor in the building?
The second floor would be a
name and you can begin.
The co-chair. 50 of an existing mixed-use building, as they said, 11 U that position.
And U 990 application, and we call up Eric Palacio, Andrew.
Be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, and that you will answer all questions truthfully.
And in the city, you see some of them, and outside. Door in the front. Conduit and the casino, and we're immediately adjacent. We'll see the ruins of that 1950s gas station. Applications are waiting in, and Committee Board 10. They are well landscaped. They have grass to the extent that they can. I say that because gas stations sometimes are not well maintained and sometimes they could be. It was also so we're hoping by providing a nice spot for them.